Can eating too much protein actually be a bad thing? Some of you might already know how much I love preaching protein, both in my videos and across social media. Side note, you should totally follow me on Instagram for more protein goodness at Picturefit. Normally, I prescribe that for healthy individuals, 1.6 grams to 2.3 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight is ideal for virtually all fitness goals. My reasoning for more than the usual 0.8 grams you might see elsewhere is quite heavily outlined in my previous work, so check that out if you're interested to learn more. But what about eating even more than what I recommend? Would more protein actually have more benefits, or do things turn for the worse? Today, let's jump into the research to find out. Now, when we think about goals like weight and fat loss, general recommendation is to adjust the amount of carbs and fats we are eating. Protein rarely is ever the primary focus, and is often simply assumed that eating too much protein like carbs and fats would also lead to weight and fat gain. However, it doesn't seem like this is always the case, or at least not for both weight and fat. A 2014 study in the Journal of International Society of Sports Nutrition found that, for 8 weeks, eating a very high protein diet while eating the same amount of carbs and fat as a control group did increase weight, but no changes to fat while adding more fat-free mass. But the juicy part is in the details. The high protein group ate lots of protein, a staggering 4.4 grams per kilogram of body weight. For an average 80 kilogram individual, that's 352 grams of protein per day. This study, however, involved slightly lighter folks with an average of 307 grams of protein per day. Still, quite a huge lot of protein. But perhaps the most eye-opening statistic is not the protein, but the total calories. On average, the high protein diet group ate roughly 800 more calories than they normally do. And yet, they only gained 1.6 kilograms of weight on average within 8 weeks, and most of it was fat-free mass, not fat. So what does this tell us? For one, this goes right against the proverbial all calories are equal. Frankly though, if we've been following the research, this has always kind of been the case when considering the different uses we have for each macronutrient. The macronutrients, carbs and fats, are primarily used for energy, thus the body will prioritize them for energy systems, and any excess carbs and fats will be stored energy in ways of fat. Protein is kind of magical in the sense that it's rarely used as energy since our body has many uses for it, like building muscle. Also, it takes a lot of energy to actually metabolize protein, so it would be best if it wasn't used for it. Another point I've been emphasizing, especially with infographics on my Instagram at Picturefit, is the thermic effect of food. In short, protein requires a great deal of energy to digest and absorb, with some estimates of 35% of its energy provision used for digestion versus carbs and fats 5 to 15%. In essence, if you eat more protein, you naturally burn more calories, and it's been shown to be even higher the more fit you are. Now, the researchers of this study believe that there could actually be potentially greater body composition changes, especially when previous studies, like a 2012 study by Bray et al., found a very clear and distinct positive relationship between lean body mass and protein intake, with no differences in fat mass. This led to the researchers to run another experiment. They believe the lack of body composition changes in their previous study wasn't due to a potential limit to protein intake, but likely because the subjects were not given a proper periodized training program. So in 2015, for another 8 weeks, the researchers compared a protein diet of 2.3 grams per kilogram of body weight versus a high protein diet of 3.4 grams while deploying the subjects into a periodized resistance training program 5 times a week. This time with the results, while eating much more calories again, the high protein subjects did not gain any weight, but the lower protein group did. Fat-free mass increased in both groups again, with no statistically significant differences. But the major difference is in fat mass. Fat mass decreased on average by only 0.3 kilograms in lower protein subjects, which is not statistically meaningful. With higher protein intake, fat mass dropped by a significantly higher 1.6 kilograms. This is a 20.2% to 19.6% body fat percentage change in the lower protein subjects, and an 18.3 to 15.9% body fat change in the high protein group. Bear in mind again, both groups were eating much more calories than usual and still dropped fat while not gaining weight with the higher levels of protein. In essence, and the answer to this video, having a decent training program paired with eating lots of protein isn't all that much a bad thing, but instead can potentially help you build muscle while losing fat given you are training sufficiently. Now, some of you might be thinking, and for good reason, is eating this much protein actually safe? In the 2015 study, the researchers did measure certain protein-related health variables, such as glomerular filtration rate and creatinine, and found no changes when eating the high-protein diet. But this was only an 8-week study. Long-term effects are still unknown, and if you have related pre-existing issues, then please take these findings with a huge grain of salt and consult your healthcare professional first. Even then, I personally wouldn't recommend more than my usual 1.6 grams to 2.3 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. Luckily, there doesn't seem to be much of a long-term risk in this range as long as you're healthy. I've talked about this in other videos as well as in my infographics on my Instagram at Picturefit, so please come check that out if you like. Other than that, please let me know what you think about eating super high amounts of protein. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a super thumbs up and share it with your protein-loving friends. As always, thank you for watching and, fittingly, get your protein.